You guys, you probably heard about the Impossible Drive or the M Drive. We literally just did a video about it, but there's already an update. Hey, spaced out DNews fans, Trace here for a DNews update. This past weekend, we posted a video about the M Drive, a resonant cavity thruster that could allegedly move through space without expelling matter to push against, potentially violating a basic law of Newtonian physics. It's a great video. What timing we had, though, because several hours before we put the video up, NASA's paper on the so-called Impossible Drive hit the hot sheets of the American Institute of Aeronautics and Astronautics Journal of Propulsion and Power. One of my favorites. NASA's Eagle Works Laboratories in Houston assayed the thrust from a Q thruster. Q thrusters are quantum vacuum plasma thrusters. According to NASA theories, Q thrusters push off quantum particles to generate movement, like a propeller for the quantum ocean of space. This family of thrusters includes the M drive, but also other designs like the Ken A and Mach-Lorentz drives. So the Q thruster NASA tested produced approximately 1.2 millinewtons per kilowatt, which is pretty significant. It's two orders of magnitude more than other out there tech like light sails, which use the power of the solar wind or lasers, but less than the potential of ion thrusters that shoot individual charged particles, and technically, ion thrusters aren't really propellant free anyway. You can see videos on all of these things here on DNews. To test this, they put their Q thruster on a low thrust torsion pendulum. Basically, it's an uber-balanced rotational arm to measure micronewton thrust. The pendulum was balanced perfectly to give the thruster experiment the illusion of zero gravity conditions, and then the whole setup was placed inside a vacuum chamber to eliminate any movement of air. They even dampened any, quote, harmonic or oscillatory motions as well as vibrations, and they registered 1.2 millinewtons per kilowatt. Then they ran a bunch of experiments to make sure that the thrust that they measured wasn't simply expansion due to heat, electricity running through the system, or anything else they could think of. They even called it out in the paper, saying errors could be from radio frequencies bouncing off the inside of the vacuum chamber, magnetic interaction from the power cables, heating of the pendulum itself, unaccounted for vibrations, electrostatic interaction, outgassing, even stray photons were accounted for, and they still registered 1.2 millinewtons per kilowatt. But before you celebrate in the streets, a published paper does not mean the Impossible Drive is perfect, or even that it works. Mostly, what the publishing of a paper indicates is an experiment was reviewed by the researchers' peers and found to be valid, meaning no obvious experimental F-ups. The researchers even admitted that they still need to account for the heating of the components, but holy crap, this thing could work. True propellantless propulsion could mean we could get to the moon in hours or to Mars in days. But before you get excited, scientists aren't yet convinced. And until they rule out all the different errors that they can think of, they're going to keep researching. So watch this space. If you are thoroughly confused by this whole thing and want to know WTF is this M drive Trace is on about, find out in this video. And subscribe and like and share and tell us what planet you'd go to if you could in the comments. And thanks for watching.